Each airport in the national airspace system has distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas. From the flight deck. Nashville International Airport is a medium to large-sized multi-use airport. It serves air carriers as well as general aviation, cargo operations, and the military. It boasts three parallel runways, 220, left, right, and center, as well as an intersecting runway 1331. A complex series of taxiways provides access to terminals, FBOs, and cargo ramps located on all sides of the airport. One problem at Nashville is that pilots sometimes fail to correctly identify their landing runway when the airport is landing to the southwest. Several incidents have occurred when aircraft cleared to land on runway 20 center have actually landed or attempted to land on runway 20 right. The runways are closely spaced. However, the threshold for runway 20 center is considerably further south than the threshold for 20 right. Aircraft flying a right downwind for 20 center may be tempted to land 20 right, as it is the first runway they see from their perspective in the pattern. Of course, there could be serious consequences if an aircraft lands on an incorrect runway or on a taxiway, so pilots need to pay extra attention in locating their assigned runway. The complex taxiway structure at Nashville includes taxiway Sierra, which is parallel to runway 20 center. Although taxiway Sierra is marked and lighted at only 75 feet in width, its shoulders are wider than typical on the north end, as it was a runway in the past. Pilots taxiing to runway 20 center via taxiways Sierra 6 and Sierra 7 have attempted to depart from taxiway Sierra instead of runway 20 center. Pilots need to exercise caution when utilizing runway 20 center and ensure they line up on the runway, not the taxiway. Visual clues include large yellow surface-painted letters TAXI on taxiway Sierra at Sierra 6 and Sierra 7, in addition to runway markings, signage, and lighting. Taxiway lights are blue, runway lights are white. Another area of potential confusion, denoted by hotspot 3, occurs with aircraft, predominantly air carriers, taxiing to runway 2 right, 20 left, via Lima, Romeo Hotel. Sometimes pilots miss the slight left turn onto taxiway Romeo, resulting in them continuing straight on taxiway Lima 8. This could lead to the pilot inadvertently crossing runway 31. Understanding taxi clearances and being aware of this configuration will help avoid this difficult situation. Small aircraft landing runway 20 left need to be aware that the tower or ground controller may not be able to see them if they clear the runway at Hotel 4 or Hotel 5. Unless specifically asked, a clear of the runway call is not required, but in this instance may be helpful for the tower. Pilots need to be aware that there are two vehicle access roads that connect to runway 20 left, 2 right. These two vehicle access roads are located in between taxiways Hotel 3 and Hotel 4. These two roads are wide enough to be confused for a taxiway. Tower monitors for this hazard, but your awareness is key to avoiding this mistake. Pilots should note that there is a ramp tower that controls most of the terminal ramp area. Be aware of the hours of operation and the areas of responsibility that this ramp tower covers. When the ramp tower is closed, the terminal ramp is uncontrolled, and the UNICOM frequency, 122.95, should be used for pilot-to-pilot coordination. Please refrain from asking ground about parking issues or gate pushbacks in this area. As with most busy airports, Nashville would seem to be in a continuous state of construction. Close attention needs to be paid to NOTAMs and construction notices prior to departing for the airport. Once at the airport, close attention to clearances and signage will help you get to where you want to go. Pilots need to be aware of the approach hold lines for runway 20 center on taxiway Kilo. Too many pilots have missed these lines and failed to hold short, even after reading back their correct hold short instructions. This situation has resulted in landing aircraft on final for runway 20 center having to be sent around. It may not always be immediately obvious what a hold short line is protecting or why they are placed in specific locations. A quick look at the airport diagram, however, will make it clear to pilots why they must hold short at this location when instructed to do so. Prior to reaching Nashville, pilots need to be aware that VFR aircraft may be encountered while on final approach or departure. This occurs predominantly north and south of the airport, outside the inner ring and under the outer shelf, with aircraft transiting east and west without talking to ATC. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at the Nashville International Airport will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video will assist you in your trip to Nashville International Airport. It is always better to know before you go.